Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject gas dynamics and jet propulsion. Today, this is lecture number 4 on the topic stagnation properties. We solve few problems on the stagnation properties using the basic equations. So we recap from the previous discussion. We discussed the stagnation properties, impulse function. We have written the equation for stagnation temperature, stagnation enthalpy, and we discussed the effect of Mach number on the compressibility. We also discussed the Mach waves and the Mach cones. Today we are going to solve problems on the stagnation property. So the learning outcome for the today's lecture. At the end of the lecture, the student will be you will be able to solve problems on your own on the stagnation properties. And we review the equations what we are going to use for the problem solving. The stagnation temperature TO equal to T plus C square by 2 Cp, or TO by T equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 m square. The stagnation pressure is PO by P equal to TO by T to the power gamma by gamma minus 1, which is also equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 m square to the power gamma by gamma minus 1. The stagnation density rho o by rho equal to TO by T to the power 1 by gamma minus 1, which is also equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 m square to the power 1 by gamma minus 1. The energy equation stagnation enthalpy, which is given by HO equal to A square by gamma minus 1 plus C square by 2, which is also equal to C max square by 2, which is also equal to AO square by gamma minus 1. And the impulse function F equal to PA plus rho A C square. And we take the example number 9. Air being released from a tire through the valve is found to have the temperature of 15 degrees Celsius. Assume that the air in the tire is at a temperature of 30 degrees Celsius. Find the velocity of the air at the exit of the valve. The process can be assumed to be adiabatic. Take Cp equal to 1004 joules per kilogram Kelvin. The given temperature, given data, temperature at the outlet of the valve is 15 degrees Celsius. The temperature inside the tire, which is stagnation temperature, 30 degrees Celsius. And Cp, specific heat of the air, is 1004 joules per kilogram Kelvin. From the definition of stagnation temperature, TO equal to T plus C square by 2 Cp. Rearranging, C equal to square root of 2 Cp into TO minus T. It is equal to 2 into 1004 multiplied by 30 minus 15 equal to 173.55 meters per second. So the answer, velocity of the air is 173.55 meters per second. Example number 10. An airplane can fly at a speed of 800 kilometers per hour at sea level, where the temperature is 15 degrees Celsius. If the airplane flies at the same Mach number at an altitude where the temperature is 230 Kelvin, find the speed at which the airplane is flying at this altitude. So the given data, the speed is 800 kilometers per hour, temperature at the sea level is 15 degrees Celsius, and temperature at the altitude is 230 Kelvin. Now take gamma equal to 1.4 and R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin for air. So these properties are not given. We can assume suitably. The speed of the airplane, which is given in kilograms, kilometers per hour, that is C equal to 800 multiplied by 1000 divided by 3600, which is 222.2 meters per second. 222.2 meters per second. Mach number of the airplane, M equal to C by A. At the sea level, M equal to C by A, which is 222.2 divided by square root of 1.4 and 287 into 288. At the sea level, the temperature is 15 degrees Celsius, which is 288 Kelvin. So the Mach number is 0.65. For the same Mach number, the speed of the airplane at new altitude, C equal to M into A, which is equal to M into square root of gamma RT, equal to 0.65 into square root of 1.4 into 287, and the new temperature is 230 Kelvin, so this is equal to 197.6 meters per second. So the answers are, answer Mach number equal to 0.65, and speed of the airplane at new altitude, C equal to 197.6 meters per second. In example number 11, determine the stagnation pressure and temperature of air steam at 2.5 bar and 500 Kelvin with a velocity of 400 meters per second. And the given data is P equal to 2.5 bar, temperature equal to 500 Kelvin, velocity equal to 400 meters per second. And if we take the properties of the air, gamma equal to 1.4, Cp equal to 1004 joules per kilogram Kelvin, and R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin for air. And the stagnation temperature, TO equal to T plus C square by 2 Cp, which is 500 plus 400 square plus divided by 2 into 1004, which is 579.68 Kelvin. And the stagnation pressure of the air, PO equal to P into TO by T to the power gamma by gamma minus 1, which is 2.5 into 579.68 divided by 500 to the power 1.4 divided by 1.4 minus 1 equal to 2.52 bar. The answers are stagnation temperature is 579.68 Kelvin and the stagnation pressure is 2.52 bar. And example 12, the air with gamma equal to 1.38 and Cp equal to 1.05 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, having a pressure of 0.5 megapascal and temperature 500 Kelvin, flow with a velocity of 220 meters per second through a 300 millimeter diameter duct. Calculate the Mach number, stagnation pressure, stagnation temperature, stagnation density, and mass flow rate of the air. So the given data, pressure equal to 0.5 megapascal, temperature equal to 500 Kelvin, velocity equal to 220 meters per second, diameter equal to 300 millimeter, gamma equal to 1.38, Cp equal to 1.05 kilojoules per kilogram. The gas constant R equal to Cp into gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 1050 into 1.38 minus 1 divided by 1.38 is equal to 289 joules per kilogram Kelvin. The Mach number M equal to C by A, which is equal to C by square root of gamma R into T, which is 220 divided by 1.38 into 289 into 500, square root of 1.38 into 289 into 500, which is equal to 0.49. And the stagnation temperature, TO equal to T into 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M square, which is 500 into 1 plus 1.38 minus 1 divided by 2 into 0.49 square, which is equal to 522.8 Kelvin. In the stagnation pressure, PO equal to P into TO by T to the power gamma by gamma minus 1, which is 0.5 into 1000 into 522.8 divided by 500 to the power 1.38 divided by 1.38 minus 1, which is 587.93 kilopascal. Stagnation density is rho equal to PO by R into TO, which is 587.93 into 1000 divided by 289 into 522.8 equal to 3.89 kilograms per meter cube. And the static density rho equal to P by R into T, which is 500 into 1000 divided by 289 into 500, which is 3.46 kilograms per meter cube. Mass flow rate M equal to rho AC, which is rho into pi by 4 D square into C. So 3.46 into pi by 4 into 0.3 square into 220, which is equal to 53.78 kilograms per second. So the answers are Mach number equal to 0.49, stagnation pressure equal to 587.93 kilopascal, stagnation temperature is 522.8 Kelvin, stagnation density is 3.89, and the mass flow rate is 53.78 kilograms per second. And example 13, air at 3 bar and 27 degrees Celsius enters a duct of varying cross-sectional area at 150 meters per second. The area at inlet is 150 meters per second. Velocity 150 meters per second. Area at inlet section is 0.05 meters square. Another section at the downstream, the pressure is 2 bar, temperature is 270 Kelvin, velocity is 250 meters per second. And assuming air to be perfect gas, find the internal thrust produced. So, given data, P1 equal to 3 bar, T1 equal to 27 degrees Celsius, C1 equal to 150 meters per second, and the area at the inlet is 0.05 meters square. At another section downstream, P2 equal to 2 bar, T2 equal to 270 Kelvin, and Cd equal to 50 meters per second. You take gamma equal to 1.4 and R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin for the air, and the density of the air at the inlet, rho 1 equal to P1 by R into T1, so 3 into 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 300, which is equal to 3.48 kilograms per meter cube. Mass flow rate M equal to rho 1 A1 C1, which is 3.48 into 0.05 into 150 equal to 26.1 kilograms per second. Density at the outlet, rho t equal to P2 by R into T2, which is equal to 2 into 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 270, which is 2.58 kilograms per meter cube. And area at the outlet, A t equal to M divided by rho to C2, which is 26.1 divided by 2.58 into 250, which is equal to 0.04 meter square. Now the thrust at the inlet, F1 equal to P1 A1 plus rho 1 A1 C1 square. So 3 into 10 power 5 into 0.05 plus 3.48 into 0.05 into 150 square equal to 18,950 Newton. And thrust at the outlet, F2 equal to P2 A2 plus rho 2 A2 C2 square, which is 2 into 10 power 5 into 0.04 plus 2.58 into 0.04 into 250 square, which is 14,450 Newton. And the net thrust to produce F equal to F2 minus F1 equal to 14,450 minus 18,915 is equal to minus of 4,465 Newton. The answer is thrust to produce is F equal to minus of 4,465 Newton. In example 14, an airplane is traveling at 1,500 kilometers per hour at an altitude where the temperature is minus 60 degrees Celsius. What is the Mach number of the flight? So the given data, speed of the airplane is 1,500 kilometers per hour and temperature is minus 60 degrees Celsius. So speed of the airplane is 1,500 into 1,000 divided by 3,600, which is 416 meters per second. So the kilometer to meter multiplying by 1,000, hour converting into second divided by 3,600, which is 416.7 meters per second. Mach number of the airplane, M equal to C by A, which is C by square root of gamma RT, which is 416.7 divided by square root of 1.4 into 287, 273 minus 60, the temperature is minus 60 degrees Celsius, so this is equal to 1.42. So the Mach number of the airplane is 1.42. And example 15, air at the 80 degree Fahrenheit flowing with a Mach number of 1.9, find the air velocity at the Mach angle. So the given data, T equal to 80 degree Fahrenheit, which is 26.67 degrees Celsius, and Mach number equal to 1.9, and velocity of the air, C equal to M into A, which is equal to M into square root of gamma R into T, which is 1.9 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 299.67, which is 205.93 meters per second. And the Mach angle is alpha equal to 1 sine inverse of 1 by M, which is sine inverse of 1 by 1.9 equal to 31.76 degrees. And the answers are velocity of the air equal to 205.93 meters per second, and the Mach angle is 31.76 degrees Celsius. So we solved the problem only the basic equations, so which you have to remember and solve the problem. And this is the book what I referred for solving the problem. So you can also have a copy, and all the support, theoretical derivation, everything is available in the book published by another publications. And if there is any query on the subject, so you can write to me to this mail ID. I will answer your queries. So thank you. We'll meet again.